So here we have Trio. And Trio is a startup from China. They have a bunch of venture capital and a cleaning company. And it's cute. It's slow. This is a prototype. It's not working. They sold 125. They want to release it to quarter three. And let's see if I can jump in front of it. Yeah, it stops. It stopped. It didn't hit me. So it can have water and it can work 4 hours on batteries. But the real interesting thing is it's nicely done. The software is interesting. And this one sells not for 30,000 like the German ones, the 20,000 like Kesker, but this one sells for 9,000 euro. So 9,000 euro is really very competitive. And you see that this company, you see the design, how much attention they pay to detail, how much attention they pay to the software. It's going to be very interesting. And so here you see how the computer sees the room. And of course, this is a software game. How well can you map out the room? How intelligently can you drive around the robot? And this is not a cleaning company. This is a software robotic company with people from Beijing and from Shenzhen and from Hong Kong. And it's really going to be interesting to see how far they're going to be next year. Trio, and I'm talking to Paul Chi, he's the CEO of a startup company which makes robots, autonomous driving robots, which are cute. They're small, they're cute, they can run around, and they are not from a cleaning company. You are a startup, right? Where are you located?
We're located in Beijing, and we have a development center and also software development in Shenzhen and Hong Kong.
Yeah, okay, Shenzhen is where you can make, where everything is made, and why are you in Beijing?
Oh, actually, that's where you can get closer to the market, and we're a startup. You definitely need to tell more people about your story, and Beijing is a nice place.
Yeah. What kind of funders do you have?
I studied in Hong Kong, yeah. Then I moved back for Uber in Shenzhen. I worked there for 2 years, then we found this opportunity together, and my partner, my CTO, is actually coming from Chinese University of Hong Kong, and he studied robotics for over 10 years now.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, he did his master's, PhD, and blah, 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 so he's robots. So this is just one area you're applying your robotic skills to. You're not a cleaning guy by nature.
Exactly. That's the reason why. I mean, we look around for different markets. Actually, the robotics market in China is booming right now. You have service robot and all sorts of things. When we look around the whole horizon, we think this is our best shot.
I mean, I would imagine there is enough people in China with low salaries to do cleaning. Why do you think that there's a big market for robots, or cleaning robots?
Exactly. I think what you observe is definitely correct, but only in 10 years ago. I mean, 10 years ago, you have tons of people who are willing to do low wages job, yeah. Just like this. Yeah. But all this baby boomer, they're aging fast, right? And right now, they're in their 60s or even 70s. It's just really hard to see them to go into a job like this every single day, right? Mm-hmm. And I think all the companies or even the society needs something new innovation to supply this amount of labor hours. Right?
Okay, you think there's going to be a shortage of labor in China because they're aging so fast?
Yes, exactly. That's our main cutting.
Okay, yeah. So the two of you got together and made this company. Who are your investors? What kind of investors do you have and what interest do they have?
We have a well-known VC back in Beijing, and we have one of the commercial cleaning outsourcing company backing us up. Yeah, so that's us.
Okay. And they've invested a couple of million to do this whole first startup. You're now doing a tour around the world.
Exactly.
So what is the experience with something like this? I mean, at the moment, it's a prototype, right? It's not a production thing they show around. Yep. And the thing which is different than all the other ones, it's a little bit designed nicely. Yeah. And it's cheap, right? What is the price? What's the price going to be?
Okay, so right now at the show, we're starting at 999 euro.
Yeah.
So just over 10,000.
Yeah. So 10,000 euro, and what are the characteristics of this robot? What can it do? How fast and how many hours and how many square meters can it do?
Yeah. Okay. So this one right now, we tune it down to 0.5 meters per second, mm-hmm. and actually we're planning to boom it up to 1.5. So that means we can cover 3,000 square meters per second, probably hopefully by end of the year. And the reason why we tune it down to tune the speed down is that we don't want to really make a scene.
You don't want to scare people. Yeah, okay. How do you figure out the room? How is the vision system of the robot developed?
Of course, we have industrial grade LiDAR, and actually it can detect
LiDAR.
So it can detect up to 25 meters on each side. And actually, whenever it enters a new environment, and we have an app to control it, to scan the whole thing, and we know where the obstacles, for example, walls or stationary obstacles. Mm-hmm. And from there, once it's finished, you should be able to tell which area in the map you want this machine to go to clean.
Yeah, and the user interface is going to be extremely important to have nice, which normal human beings can understand, right?
I think it's go beyond normal human being, but when you think about all these people, they're in their 60s or 70s, you want to give them an app, they want to use it. Yeah, of course, I mean, usability is definitely a concern, and that's the reason why we should spend more time onto it.
Yeah, you started in?
I'm sorry?
The company was started in?
The company was started in end of 2016. So a little bit, one year and a half.
When is this thing going to co-production?
I think we're going to start the production in about a quarter time, so we should be able to deliver in Q4.
How fast can you ramp up production with a robot like this?
I think at the beginning of the Q4, we should be able to churn out 10 to 15 robots per week, and hopefully towards the end of the year, we should be able to churn out 100 of them every week.
How many partners do you already have in different parts of the world?
I think in China, we actually have a strong distribution network. So we have a distribution network in Shanghai, Beijing, Shenzhen, and also in Chengdu to the west. Mm-hmm. And actually, that's the China show happens in Shanghai. So we already sold 125 of them.
Yep.
That's where we have to deliver in 3 months' time. So
what about here? How much interest did you have here? And what kind of partner are you looking for in Europe?
Yeah, actually, we come here to look for a partner with a strong distribution network as well. We realize how valuable that is. Mm-hmm. Unfortunately, on day one, we haven't really talked to enough people yet, so I hope I can have a lot more interest.
And what is a strong distribution? It doesn't have to be a high-tech company. It has to have a strong distribution network who wants to modernize the equipment.
Yeah, I think that once you have to know this market enough to push this new product. But like you said, I mean, we really like our partner to have this forward-looking vision, just like ourselves, so we can do it together.
Yeah, and you want to learn from the cleaning markets, and you can teach them about the gadgets. What about America?
Actually, we're going to America in end of October for the ISA show over there, and actually we're looking for the similar things. So yeah, wish of luck.
Okay, I wish you luck. What will be success in if we stand here 2 years from now with Interclean 2020? When will you be happy?
Oh, I think that's a lot of more people can come to our booth, and they're gonna not only to about this show. I hope by that time, 2 years later, you're gonna see it everywhere in Amsterdam, in your office building, for example. That's where it's gonna make me happy.
Okay. So here we have Trio from China who have a big ambition to conquer the world.